Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O Lord and Father, our King and God, by whose grace the Church was enriched by thy great learning and eloquent preaching of thy servant Lancelot Andrews, but even more by his example of biblical and liturgical prayer, conform our lives like his, we beseech thee, to the image of Christ, that our hearts may love thee, our minds serve thee, and our lips proclaim the greatness of thy mercy. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from the first epistle of St. Paul to Timothy. First of all, then, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high positions, so that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and dignity. This is right and is acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who desires everyone to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, there is also one mediator between God and humankind, Christ Jesus himself, human, who gave himself a ransom for all. This was attested to at the right time. For this I was appointed an herald and an apostle. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The psalm appointed for today is a portion of Psalm 63, verses 1 through 8, found beginning on page 670 of the Book of Common Prayer, the first 8 verses of Psalm 63. O God, you are my God. Eagerly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh faints for you, as in a barren and dry land where there is no water. Therefore I have gazed upon your holy place, that I may behold your power and your glory. For your loving kindness is better than life itself. My lips shall give you praise. So will I bless you as long as I live, and lift up my hands in your name. My soul is content as with marrow and fatness, and my mouth praises you with joyful lips. When I remember you upon my bed, and meditate on you in the night watches. For you have been my helper, and under the shadow of your wings I will rejoice. My soul clings to you, your right hand holds me fast. Thank you. Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke. Glory be to thee, O Lord. Jesus was praying in a certain place, and after he had finished, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciples. He said to them, When you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us. And do not bring us to the time of trial. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise be to thee, O Christ. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Today we celebrate the feast of Anselm Andrews, and I'll read to you just a little bit about him. He was a distinguished biblical scholar, proficient in Hebrew and Greek, and was one of the translators of the King James Bible. He was Dean of Westminster and headmaster of the school there before he became a bishop, and was influential in the education of a number of noted churchmen of his time, in particular the poet George Herbert. Andrews was a very devout man, and one of his most admired works is his Praeces Privatae, Private Devotions, an anthology from the scriptures and the ancient liturgies compiled for his own use. It illustrates his piety and throws light on the sources of his theology. He vigorously defended the Catholicity of the Church of England against Roman Catholic critics. He was respected by many as the very model of a bishop at a time when bishops were held in low esteem. As his student John Hackett, later the Bishop of Lichfield, wrote about him, indeed, he was the most apostolical and primitive-like divine, in my opinion, that wore a rochet in his age, of a most venerable gravity, and yet most sweet in all commerce, the most devout that I ever saw. When he appeared before God, of such a growth in all kind of learning, and very able clerks were of low stature to him. Andrews is well known for his own writing, and I want to share with you some of his prayers, one of his prayers, that tells us a lot about him. He was a product of his age, the 16th century, and I'm sure I have his date, that's right. Daniel probably knows. Sorry, 16th and 17th. He died in 1626 when he was Bishop of Westminster, after being Bishop of Winchester. And he was a product of his age, and you'll hear this in his in this prayer of his, which I find that when I look over Lancelot and Andrew's prayers, lovely as they are in language, they don't always meet with the sensibilities, our own religious sensibilities, and so it seems like you need to edit them carefully. I'm not editing this at all, because I think we should hear him as he spoke. Father of mercies, I beseech thy fatherly affection. Despise me not, an unclean worm, a dead dog, a putrid corpse. Despise not thou the work of thine own hands. Despise not thine own image, though branded by sin. Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. Lord, only say the word, and I shall be cleansed. And thou, my Savior Christ, Christ my Savior of sinners, of whom I am chief, despise me not, O Lord, despise not the cost of thy blood, who am called by thy name, but look on me with those eyes with which thou didst look upon Magdalene at the feast, Peter in the hall, the thief on the wood. That with the thief I may entreat thee humbly, remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. That with Peter I may bitterly weep and say, Oh, that mine eyes were a fountain of tears, that I might weep day and night. That with Magdalene I may hear thee say, Thy sins be forgiven thee. And with her may love much, for many sins, yea, manifold, have been forgiven me. And thou, all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, despise me not. Thy breath despise not thine own holy things, but turn thee again, O Lord, the last, and be gracious unto thy servant. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Now let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. thanks for all men. Receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching you to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and in unity and godly love. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Daniel, our bishop, and Nora, Stephen, Nicholas, and Gordon, my priest brothers and sisters who worship at work in this place and parish, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments, and to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. We beseech thee also so to rule the hearts of those who bear the authority of government in this and every land, especially Donald, our president, the members of the Congress and the courts, Tom, our governor, and Jim, our mayor, and all those in positions of authority and public trust in these days of pandemic and protest, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world. Open, O Lord, the eyes of all people to behold thy gracious hand in all thy works, that rejoicing in thy whole creation, they may honor thee with their substance and be faithful stewards of thy bounty. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who are sick with coronavirus, all doctors, nurses, medical workers, and other essential workers who put themselves at risk for the benefit of others, all those who are unemployed and anxious or worried about their livelihoods, their families, their careers, and their well-being, all those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, who struggle for justice that's been denied, and who work to bring about an end to the sin of racism in our hearts and in our society, all those who are in danger because of the fires of the West and the storms of the South, and all those members of this parish community who are sick or in trouble of any kind. Remember especially to pray for Chris, George, Sue, Tom, Kent John, George, John, Mary Jane, Marlene, Richard, Will, Kathy, Jan, Jean, T.R., Bill, Janet, Mike, Larry, Homer, Tim, Paul, Sarah, Nathan, Lee, Armand, and all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, especially all those who died from the coronavirus in the past day, and all of those whose lives have been taken from them in acts of war and violence in recent days. Beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to grant us grace, so to follow the good examples of the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, of blessed Mark the Evangelist, of blessed Lancelot Andrews, and of all thy saints, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with heart of repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins. confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Offer to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving, and make good your vows to the Most High. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Of your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Of your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord receive this sacrifice at my hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both for our good and for that of all his holy church. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God, for the wonderful grace and virtue declared in all thy saints, who have been the chosen vessels of thy grace, and the lights of the world in their generations. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks, for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness, vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord,
trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that takest away the sins of the world. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of God.